All right, well, now to politics here. And Julia Gillard always insists she never pays much attention to the polls, but you'd have to think she'd be quietly surprised with the results from the latest ones. Our National Affairs editor, Paul Bongiorno, is tonight in Canberra. Paul, there's been a shift in public opinion, quite a shift in public opinion when it comes to the PM and Labor. Why is that?
Well, Matt, it's a bit hard to pin down, but if we go to the average of the four major opinion polls since July, July is quite significant because that's when the balloon went up on Tony Abbott's scare campaign over the carbon tax. This graphic tracks those polls, and you can see a gap of 14% just 3 months ago, narrowing down to 6% now. So this, as it were, takes out some of the bumps in the polls and shows that definite narrowing. Of course, what's happened in this period, Julia Gillard's gone on to areas more comfortable for her in Labor, education, health and disability, and she's had enormous help from Tony Abbott's colleagues in the States, especially in Queensland, with the slashing and the burning.
And Paul, one of the polls asked about the leader's attributes. What did that find?
Look, Essential Poll today listed a number of attitudes in its poll, attributes rather, and found the attitudes of the electorate not really good news for Tony Abbott. The more interesting ones I found here were more honest and trustworthy than most politicians. Julia Gillard, 31%, ahead of Tony Abbott on 27%. Trustworthy. Tony Abbott is line ball with Julia Gillard, even though he says she's the most untrustworthy Prime Minister we've ever had and has called her a liar every day for the last 18 months or so. And then when it comes to aggression and intolerance, he's a country mile ahead, which probably explains why those accusations and recalling of what he was like as a student politician was so toxic for the opposition leader.
Interesting results indeed. Thanks, Paul Bongiorno in Canberra.